Wow, I forgot it's that close. Praise the Lord. Church, really, is what you make of it. It's neither good nor bad. It's not black or white. It's not red or yellow. It's not one building or one structure. But church is something that God uses for us to benefit us in relationship to knowing Him. It's something that we get the opportunity to participate in. It's something that we can do or not do, and choose to do it either joyfully or religiously. We can do it practically. We can do it emotionally. We can do it spiritually. As a matter of fact, there's a lot to be said about church that you can do a word study on it and find out all kinds of things about called out ones or assembled ones or tabernacles or all of these things that people make in their religious way of defining what church is. But really, church is what you make of it. Because, you see, wherever you go, however you are there with God. Now, you may not believe in God, but God is still there. He still exists. He's still the Lord God, creator of the universe. So, the fact that God has given us the opportunity to know Him is why He's made available to us the venue or avenue or way that we call the church. Now, it's not like the Catholic Church or the Protestant Church or some church that you want to put a name and a label on. The church really is something that God uses wherever you are, however you are, the way you are. He comes to you by way of His Spirit. Now, if you don't know Him, then He's working on you to get you to know Him in a more personal, intimate way than you've ever known Him before. That's kind of what He does outside the church. But then He brings you inside the church because He's working to get inside your life so that you could get to know Him in a more personal and intimate way, to understand Him, to be aware of His presence when He's aware or when He's near you, even next to you, maybe standing or sitting right where you're at. You see, God can unveil Himself at any point in time. He could reveal Himself through His Son, Jesus, or He could reveal Himself as He lives inside of His believers, the people whom He has called by His name. Those are called Christians, or little Christ, or little Jesuses, because they're meant to be like Jesus. It doesn't mean they are. It just means they're meant to be. And that's what church is for most people. It is those people that have gotten together, kind of like in His name, in order to do what God wants them to do for His glory. Now, a lot of people will take a negative approach to church. They'll say, oh, well, I've had this bad experience. Well, I think you made it what you wanted it to be. Because you see, church can be anywhere you go. Church, you could go down the street and check out another church or go to a different one. You see, really, church is what you make of it. Because if you don't like where you're at, go somewhere else. Believe me, the people that are in your church will appreciate you going somewhere else more than if you stayed and complain about it. Now, most people usually find some place that blesses them, encourages them, matter of fact, inspires them or causes them to get to know God personally in a more intimate way than they've ever known before, as well as some things that they never understood before. In other words, they, by way of this collective agreement, they come to this unity of the faith and they become one with God and what He's doing. And since God's in the driver's seat, they get to kind of like sit in the back seat and learn all kinds of things. They get to look out the window and see what God is doing and go, ooh, this is cool. You see, that's what church is meant to be. It's not supposed to be you in charge. It's supposed to be you letting God take over. It's supposed to be you enjoying the ride. It's supposed to be you learning more about how to be less in charge than more responsible for what you think you need to do. Because the truth is, if you sat down and examined all that God has promised to do for you, if you ever read everything that God said He'll do to you, then really, once you discover grace, man, it's so easy to let go. Except we're clingy kind of people. We like to hang on to things rather than let go of them. And that's kind of why we have church. You see, people go to church in order to be encouraged and taught, to learn, to grow, to become more acquainted with this person we call God. So, whenever I go to church, I expect to hear from God. whenever I go to church, I expect to, you know, see God in the midst of his people. Whenever I'm participating in a church, I expect to hear from God and be directed by God. Matter of fact, wherever I'm at, I expect that too in my life. Because whenever you're walking in the Spirit or you're talking to God and you have fellowship with him, you expect God to meet you where you're at. And every day, for me, is church day. Every day is a day to celebrate the reality of being one with everyone that calls upon the name of the Lord. And that's kind of where I'm at when it comes to my church, because church is what you make it. But church has been made for me by way of God doing it in me to cause me to be a part of the kingdom of heaven. And the kingdom of heaven has come to earth and manifested itself to me in such a way that I go into all kinds of churches and I'm blessed. I'll go into a Catholic church or a Protestant church or Armenian church or, you know, you name it. Just about any church I've been to, man, I got blessed in some way because God talked to me. But there are times where some people really don't hear from the Lord. And I understand that. But you see, that's up to you to decide what you want to do with church. Because the church, as you consider it a building, or you consider it you being in relationship with God or not in relationship, determine what you want to do with this thing called church. You can make it into something that's a blessing for you, or you can make it into something that's a curse to you. You could fight against it and blame everything in the world on the church and claim that, oh, church history is full of this, that, or the other thing. And no offense, but you made it that way, because that's what you're making church into being. It isn't what God said church is. It's what you made it out to be. Because the reality of it is, Jesus said, even the gates of hell cannot prevail against my church. So really, since Jesus has a church, and you are a church, you also have your church. You see, your church, it's wherever you are. Now, I personally like to get my church in with some other churches so that I kind of get blessed by it, you know, because really it's kind of fun having someone to talk to, someone to relate to, someone to share with, to care for, to maybe even make known my needs so that they can help me and I can help them. That's kind of what church really is. When two or more are gathered together, Jesus is there in the midst. And Jesus said, he came to help, to give life and life more abundantly, to encourage, to exhort us. He would send us his Holy Spirit so that we would be strengthened in these times that we're coming upon, that we would know the truth, and the truth would set us free from the sins that we so easily trip up and fall into, that we would be forgiven, that we would find mercy and grace in time of need, that we would find all kinds of opportunities if we would just turn ourselves to the Lord our God and hear from him as he speaks to us in our church. Church really is what you make it out to be. It's up to you to make it into something that God can use. Because like I said before, there are churches that some are good, some are bad. Just depends on what you make of it.